Hello, I am Nicole Nelson Jean, Associate Principal Deputy Assistant Secretary for Field Operations at the Department of Energy's Office of Environmental Management. As the largest environmental cleanup program in the world, the Department of Energy's Office of Environmental Management, or EM, is responsible for safely completing cleanup resulting from decades of nuclear weapons development and government-sponsored nuclear energy research. Decades of government-funded nuclear weapons development and energy research left an environmental legacy impacting 107 sites in 35 states. To restore the land at these sites, the U.S. Department of Energy established the Office of Environmental Management in the late 1980s. Today, it manages the largest environmental cleanup program in the world. 16 sites remain with active environmental cleanup, the largest of which is the Hanford Site in the southeastern Washington state. Hanford was established by the U.S. government in 1943 as part of the top secret Manhattan Project. Hanford played a critical role in the Manhattan Project, constructing the world's first full-scale nuclear reactor in just 11 months. Ultimately, Hanford produced the plutonium for the world's first atomic test, dubbed the Trinity test, as well as for one of the weapons used to help end World War II. As the end of the Manhattan Project became the beginning of the Cold War, plutonium production at Hanford again ramped up to meet national defense needs. Hanford's last reactor was shut down in 1987, but 44 years of plutonium production at the site generated millions of tons of solid waste and contaminated soil, billions of gallons of contaminated liquids, and thousands of contaminated buildings and waste sites. 2 years later, the Energy Department's cleanup mission began. The DOE and its contractors directly employ more than 11,000 people at Hanford responsible for the cleanup mission. An annual budget of about $2.5 billion supports Hanford cleanup, about 40% of which is invested in the Hanford workforce. In addition, DOE's industry partners who carry out work at Hanford are committed to utilizing local and regional subcontractors. In fiscal year 2020, this channeled $674 million into the local economy. Today, Hanford's mission is to clean up legacy waste generated by more than 40 years of plutonium production. This includes treating contaminated soil and groundwater, cocooning the final plutonium production reactors, addressing radioactive and chemical waste stored in underground tanks, and demolishing contaminated buildings and waste sites. Tremendous cleanup progress has been made over the years. 7 out of the 9 reactors have been stabilized or preserved. The vast majority of cleanup along the Columbia River has been completed. Over 27 billion gallons of contaminated groundwater has been treated. 20 tons of plutonium has been shipped out of the state, and all 2,300 tons of spent nuclear fuel has been moved to safe, dry storage. Nearly 1,000 buildings have been demolished, including the iconic plutonium finishing plant. Today, Hanford is in a new era of progress, advancing this massive environmental effort and delivering on cleanup commitments. Hanford is rapidly advancing capabilities to address 56 million gallons of radioactive waste stored in 177 underground tanks. After decades of work, DOE is on track to begin treating some of Hanford's tank waste by the end of 2023 via the Direct Feed Low Activity Waste Program. Utilizing key parts of the waste treatment plant will be a game changer for the Hanford mission, enabling tank waste to be treated and immobilized in a glass-like form for safe disposal. The next decade will be a transformational time for Hanford. Radioactive tank waste treatment will be well underway. Significant risk reduction activities will advance, such as transferring radioactive capsules to safer dry storage, stabilizing the last of the former production reactors, and progressing work at the highly contaminated 324 building. EM's progress at Hanford will protect the Hanford workforce and the public, clean up the environment and protect the Columbia River, pave the way for a safe, vibrant future in the local Tri-Cities community.